freaking lip sync.
That's what you get.
I was like, I don't see the recording button, but
well, you guys all got it.
I think that what happens with this business is that when you first get into the business, you start like looking at other coaches and what they're doing, because you're told right away to like follow the lead of these coaches and do what these coaches are doing. And it kind of, you like get sucked into like the comparison game and, oh, they did that, I don't know how to do that. Like, you know, I'm not them, blah, 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 blah. So you kind of go through this like self-sabotage way of starting your business. And I think that it's so, so important that you just stick 100% to yourself and be you. So you have to really master your mindset and to ask yourself, how can I be different than all the other Beachbody coaches? How can I follow other successful Instagrammers and Facebook people that are not Beachbody coaches? Like, what's gonna make me stand out away from them? And I think finding that like in yourself, you like journey through like what works for you, what doesn't work for you, what information you want to take from Beachbody, what information you don't take, you know, like when it comes to like scripts and stuff. But I really think that people take off with this business when you're 100% yourself and you have fun. So like what's cool is that this is your own business. This is your business. This is not Beachbody's business. You can run this business however you want. You have the tools to guide, to be guided, but like, I want to encourage everybody to be themselves and take it on their own terms, because when you're yourself and you work for something and you do it by yourself, that lights your fire and you get excited about it because you did it yourself. So it's very, very, very important to have fun being you. You know, so I was talking to Bonnie, I'm calling her out a little bit, because she made this post about, you know, people talking about her behind, you know, in a line. And normally she would have, like she was telling me today, normally she would have just left the coffee place or left the place that she was at. And the growth that I've seen from like day one with her to now, for her to make that post, show her panties and basically be like, F you bitches, like I'm gonna stand on this line and rock it because I worked hard. Like just for her to have that confidence and do that, that's her being herself and being like, you know what? I worked really hard on personal development. I worked really hard at my health and fitness. And this is me and I'm gonna post this on Facebook. And she got a lot of traction because she was being herself. So really what I wanna say is just like, go back to the basics of your own health and fitness, and don't forget to like stop comparing yourself, and don't forget to be you. Like on your Facebook, if you're doing something, if you're like, I don't know, for me, like if I'm CrossFitting and I'm doing all this stuff, like I'm gonna share about it because I'm not, it doesn't have to just be Beachbody. Sorry, I'm getting over a cold, but basically, I just want to tell everybody to be themselves and have fun. And I go back to Kaylin too, my coach, and she says, when I figured out that I didn't have to be you, I really realized that I could do this business. So I think people lose sight that it is your own business and you can do it however you want. There's like no rules at all. So I think that that's what really what I want, you know, just what you guys are saying, like have fun and you gotta help people. And the All Access Pass is like fire. Like if you're not like excited about that, people aren't going to know. Like, you know, I don't know. I'm so excited about it. I talk about it. Like people are like, I really want to do hammer and chisel. How much is it? Oh, it's $199 and you get Shakeology and you get every other program. So it's like, stop buying them separate. You know, it's a really awesome opportunity right now. And so just take full advantage and do it in any way that you can. Doesn't matter. So that's all I really wanted to say. Cool. And I'm drinking out of 3 straws. I don't know. You guys do that. But I do.
3's a party.
Yeah, 3's a party.
I feel like I should put 5 in there right now. Like 10. Just to see.
You have anything you want to talk about before I want to know what I want to
do? I'm going
to
mute myself because my nephews are going to come in.
Okay. No, I mean, what I was going to talk about was All Access Pass, which is what Blaine basically just talked about. And so, like, really like what she said, like share about it because people don't know. And it is such an amazing deal. They're getting every single program that Beachbody has come out with available to them, plus the new programs, at least this is how I understand it, like all the new programs that come out later in the year, they'll have access to those as well. And so, like she was saying, if they're wanting to do one program, tell them about this opportunity because they're just going to get a ton. So that's basically what I personally wanted to go over. And then we have, obviously, our other things we want to talk about, and I'll chime in.
Okay. Just stop me if I get rolling okay. too much. No, so I want to thank everyone for hopping on the call
yes.
from our team and Blaine and KJ's team and Bonnie's
yeah.
team and everyone, you know, really appreciate it. Cause like what I always say is you never hop on one of these calls, whether you're working the business or your discount coach or your new coach or whatever, and come away and go, man, that sucked. No, like you're going to feel good. You're going to feel motivated. You get to see people's faces, especially with like talking on social media all the time. And you're living in different places where people, it's cool to see the people's faces that you're
yeah,
talking
and you're
to.
You're like, oh, you're real.
Yeah, you're a real person, which is cool. And for me, like, yeah, we're going to talk about business stuff on team calls, obviously, but also it's not always about that. It's. I'm glad Blaine brought that up because that's what I'm all about is fun. And that's really what we want to do on our team page in 2017 and beyond is bring back the fun. Because, you know, if you're not having fun at what you're doing, then, you know, why are you doing it? And that's the one of my biggest motivations for why I do this full time, why I quit my job, is I was hating what I was doing. I was miserable and I dreaded going to work and I'd come home and be mentally exhausted at 6 o'clock at night. And I was like, this is no way to live. So I enjoy what I do and it's fun and I make it me like Blaine was saying, like I'm not trying to copy anybody else. This is me who you get, whether you like it or not. And if you don't, that's fine too, but I'm going to keep doing it up. So be you and just have fun with it. But what I want to talk about is because it's the third day of 2017, which, you know, there's 3 days gone by, but it's already went by like crazy fast, those 3 days. And I really want to harness in on making this year count like every single day. And going back to my hockey days, my coaches are always said this, like, stay in the moment, don't get too high and too low with your emotions. And that's exactly what I encourage all you to do. And if you've been in my challenge groups or I've helped you out, and we've talked one-on-one before, this is something I really stress. And it's, you know, you can't control everything in your life. You know, as much as you want to be able to control every single situation and how life affects you, you know, you can't. But what you can control is how you react to every situation. And that's a huge thing. And, you know, it's the first of the year, so you can change your mindset starting now to change how you react to things. You know, like in the past, someone would cut me off in traffic and freak out, you know, like blaring on the horn, tailgating, cussing at them, like I'm sure we've all done before, you know, and then that little cut off in traffic spews out into the rest of my day. My whole day's ruined because somebody cut me off in traffic, and then I wake up the next morning pissed off, and it's like, okay, yeah, that happened like 20 hours ago, and I'm still letting it affect me. So it's all about how you react to the situation, and you control how you react. Like, bad stuff's going to happen. There's going to be negative situations, you know. Family members pass away, animals pass away, car trouble. Someone says something bad about you. You break a bone. Like, all that, you spill your drink in the kitchen. Like, stuff like that happens all the time. But it's how you handle and react to those situations, which is huge. So I encourage you to really, like, slow it down when stuff happens, you know, that maybe not be the best situation. Look at it like, how am I going to react to the situation? Am I going to let it ruin my day? Am I going to let it ruin my week, my month, my year? Like, I've already seen people post on Facebook
saying, I hate 2017.
Yes.
When's it over? I'm like, holy cow,
I swear to God, I saw somebody post like 2 hours
day
ago.
One,
it was like, got a speeding ticket, had to go to court, flat tire. Can't find a babysitter. 2017, you're screwing me over already. I'm like, wow, already 3 days in, like, you know, like you're already letting it like ruin you, like that mindset, like one little thing. And then what happens? We've all had it happen. It snowballs. Like, it keeps going. We've all been in dark, deep spots, you know, with negativity where it just seems like it keeps piling on and piling on. It's because you're allowing it to pile on. Like, there's like two people have the same exact job. They're like janitors, okay? One person absolutely loves being a janitor and one person hates it. It's all about perspective. Like, one of the janitors is looking at all the pastas. Like, they have a job, they get to clean things for a living, they got to make other people's lives better, they get a paycheck to provide for their family. All positives. And the other person is like, man, I clean toilets for a living. Like, I have to be dirty. I work graveyard. Like, I don't always get the recognition I deserve, yada, yada, yada. And it's a negative mindset, you know, and that's a huge thing, is changing the perspective. And something we always talk about, like, focus on the positive. Like, when bad stuff happens to us, like, it happens to everyone, we try to just calm down and go, what's the positive? Like, everything happens for a reason. Let's find the positives. Like, you know, that wasn't too fun, but there's always a positive. And that's what you have to look at. And getting it, my second point is something that I've done for 3 days straight. So I'm like, woo, killing it. I made it 3 days. Yeah. Is really focusing on the day. Like, whatever happened, so it's Tuesday, right?
Yes.
Whatever happened yesterday, on Monday, whether it was good, bad, amazing, crappy, whatever, it's done. It's over. That Monday is never going to happen again. It's gone. Whatever. Tomorrow is Wednesday. It hasn't even started yet. You can't control Wednesday. It's not even here. What you can control is you stay in the moment. You do everything to the best of your abilities as hard as you can today, Tuesday, January 3rd. And you just push yourself to the absolute limit. Focus on the positives. Do everything you can to build for the future today. Because let me tell you, if you're stressing about, you know, March and April, and what are you going to do then, and it's January 3rd, you're just setting yourself up for failure. You know, you can't control what happens in April now because it's January. Like, that's a long time away, you know, and in the grand scheme of things, like, you have a lot of time to build. And what I always say is, you relate Beachbody coaching and your life to like a workout program. I mean, it's so true, you know. You cannot go to the gym today and lose the 40 pounds that you need to lose. You can't go to the gym today running a 10-minute mile and then get down to a 5-minute mile today. What you can do is show up for yourself today and tomorrow and Thursday and Friday over and over again for the whole year, and there goes that 40 pounds, and there goes that faster mile split. And that's really what we're really focusing in on, is like, don't worry about yesterday, don't worry about tomorrow, worry about today. Like, am I doing everything I need to do today to get to my goals? And I encourage you guys, because, you know, whether you're actively working the business or not, or whether you're trying to improve your fitness or your life, your relationships or whatever, if you give 100% every single day for this entire year, which it sounds crazy, like a whole year, oh my God. 2016 went by really fast, and 2017 is going to go by really fast too. So if you give everything you actually have every single day for 2017 in your business, in your relationships, in your life, in your workouts, in your nutrition, you're going to be in an amazing spot at the start of 2018.
Yeah.
You know, like, and there's times when it gets tough and you're like, I don't want to talk to more people. I don't want to do that workout. Well, guess what the beauty of it is, guys? You have all these people staring back at you that you can reach out to and ask for help and support. And that's one of the greatest things about Beachbody and coaching, is you're not in this alone, you know? Like, if I'm struggling and I'm like, it's day six, something bad happened this morning, and like, I didn't get my coffee, I'm freaking out, and like, whatever, I'm like, oh my God, like, I have all this work to do and I didn't get my coffee, whatever. And Bonnie randomly messaged me, is me or something, like, hey, can you have a bed? Like, what up, Bonnie? Like, she's like, how's everything? I'm like, oh, I didn't get my coffee this morning, I'm freaking out, whatever. She could like gut check me and be like, dude, you didn't get your coffee, big deal. Like, it could be way worse. I'm like, oh my God, like, you're so right. Like, I just need to calm down. She's like, remember your goals, like, focus on today, do everything you said, get your tasks done, move on. And Bonnie helps me out, you know, and that's exactly what's so great, like I said, about this community, is you're not in this community. Whoa.
I also like think it's important too for you guys to, you have the all access pass, right? So it's not like the launch is the all access. So does that mean that you have to do core to force, or does that mean that you have to do this or do that program? So I really want to like encourage everybody to pick the program they want to do. Pick the program that you're excited about and treat it like a launch. Like treat it like, okay, for instance, like say if I wanted to do active core to force, like I'll be done this Sunday with the second round. What if like, maybe I want to take it back to Pio, you know, and do 60 days of yoga and invite people into just what I'm doing. Because when you do something that you want to do, you have the energy and the light because you're wanting to do that. And so it you give that off. Like, you know, when you're doing something like if you love size and you start doing size and you're just like kicking ass, people feel that energy. And so you have the all access pass. So it doesn't have to be a program that you absolutely hate. My cousin Trisha did Core to Force and she couldn't even stand it to go through the second round. She hated it. And that's her. That's like totally okay. You know, there's some programs that like, I don't know if I could do that. You know, like I was just like, nah, you know, and that's okay too. And it's not like you have to be like, I hate these programs. This is stupid or whatever. But, and it's awesome that you try them all, of course, but I think you do better when you lead with who you are. And that kind of just leads me back to like fun. You know, we say fun, have fun, have fun. So like, what is fun, right? Like, so, cause you can say that and it's like, okay, how do you have fun doing this? And I think that having fun is doing what you want, if that kind of makes sense. So when you do something that you want to do, like if you want to do like a YouTube channel that me and Bonnie were talking about, like if you want to do reviews over all the programs that you did and start talking about that on your YouTube, if you want to do a YouTube channel that I see you're rocking a baby, like if you want to talk about the day in the life of your child, like what he's done, that's when it's fun, when you are you. And that's how you start gaining a following, because more people are going to connect with you on a not fitness and health level. They're going to connect with you on a personal level that you share the same thing. Like, I mean, I'm not a mom, but I'm really close to my cousin Trisha, who's a mom. So, I mean, you might connect and be like, I haven't had a shower or gone to the bathroom by myself in like a month. Like, you know, like I just dream about taking a bath by myself with the door locked, right? So that's like what connects you to people. And when you share that stuff and you get the reactions, like Bonnie getting the reactions, we're creatures of like seeing the notifications, like the dopamines, like how Simon Sinek talked about, that you like it, you get the reaction from it or the likes and stuff. So when you talk about something that is about you and people react to it, that makes it fun. So you got to do more of what makes it fun. And I really like just kind of want to talk about like Cam, like you can't think of like all the future like stuff. Or, you know, I know that when I first came into coaching, I was like talking about Elite and Premier, and I was like, good God, I don't even know what any of that is. I'm going to be the person who like hits those things and doesn't even know it, because I don't like to track that kind of stuff. I never have. And so I just know that I'm going to hit the four vital behaviors. I'm going to have fun with my own health and fitness. And Success Club is a priority, a non-negotiable. And I think that that should be for everybody. And the reason why is because the reaping of the benefits of Success Club is so much greater than anything else. So have fun, like with your social media and stuff, but remember to do the behind the scenes work to make sure that that happens. And you have like, I mean, the All Access Pass, what? It's under $10 a month for everything. I mean, that's like, people don't even know that they like, you know, they'll get like charges on their credit card that are like fraud charges. They don't even know that that happens to them. Like, you know, like that's so cheap to have that All Access Pass. So just remember, when you talk about having fun, that it's basically being yourself. Like what do you look at on, you know, Facebook? I follow this thing on Instagram that like literally I go there every night just to watch the videos because they're hilarious. It's like this laughing lifter. Cam, you got to look at it. But I just wanted to like kind of share a little bit about that with you guys. And yeah, I'll stop talking now.
You're right. And now that's a perfect example for, especially for newer people, newer coaches that are on these calls and stuff. Like, it's awesome being on here, but like, you're never pressured to speak on here. You know, like some people like talking, some people like just sitting back and absorbing the information, you know, which is perfectly fine too. You know, like I'm never one to like call somebody out if they don't want to talk. Like if Blaine didn't want to talk, I was like, hey Blaine, you know, what's your goal for 2017? Like, I thought I could just not speak on the call. So like, don't worry about that. If you want to speak, you can unmute yourself. You can use the chat box, whatever. You don't have to worry about that. But yeah, that's a good theme, like Blaine was talking about, because that's something I always stress is like here over and over. Fun. But it really is being you and having fun. If you probably follow my social media, you've seen it, like we have fun and I like to be ridiculous and I don't really care what people think and I share some crazy stuff. And like the photo that we posted in the team pages from Summit with Blaine and Steven, who is like, I think he's like 8'6", I'm pretty sure, or something like that.
We look like his children.
We look like, we call him daddy because he's so big, which is Blaine's husband. He's a football player.
Guys, I was the shortest one in that photo. Were you wearing heels?
I was wearing heels on my women's boots a little bit, I guess. Yeah.
Like, I was the shortest one. I looked at that photo and I was like, good, goodness gracious.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, but that picture is a perfect example because I'm crazy like that. And I don't care. But I knew if I wore that people are going to be talking to me. Well, not that I wanted the attention. That's not the point. I just wanted to show people, like, be ridiculous. Who cares what people think? And as soon as we got our Uber down to downtown Nashville and I got out of the car and we started walking, people were like, well, the funniest thing is some dude actually grabbed my shoulder
thinking
and spun me around. Thought I was a chick. Spun me around and saw my beard. Thank God I grew my beard out because who knows what would happen. But he's like, whoa! I'm like, whoa, I saw your pants, but you got a beard. I was like, yeah.
I kept thinking you were Courtney. Like, not like in the dark when we were listening to the concert, like in the dark, like I like turn from Steven to turn and I'd like go to touch and I was like, oh, it's Cam, it's not Courtney.
So pretty much, I mean, you just gotta be ridiculous. Yeah. If you're crazy and weird, be crazy and weird. If you're shy, be shy. Like if you like talking about your kids, talk about your kids. If you like to just, you know, share about cooking, whatever, you know, it's really up to you. And like I said, again, it's the beauty of this business. And people always feel like they have to push a certain thing or talk a certain way or be like everyone else. And that's, no one wants to do that. Because how many times you work jobs where somebody tells you what to do and you don't want to do it? Like, go work the cash register at the front of Home Depot, or not Home Depot, I'd say Target. The front of Target on Christmas Eve for 6 hours straight. How fun does that sound? Not at all. But with this, you can be like, I don't want to do that. Nope, I'm my boss. I'm going to take a nap, and then I'm going to work out, and I'm going to talk to people and share about my journey. Like, that's fun. Like, that's freaking cool. Like, and you can talk to as many people as you want, as little people as you want. You can talk to people on Facebook on your phone while you're in the bathtub. Like, how many people get to work from their bathtub if they want? You could be drinking wine in a bubble bath on your phone working, and I guarantee you – probably 80% of the women Beachbody coaches do that exact same thing all the time. Oh yeah, bathtub Saturday nights. And I actually made a video about that last year of me in a bubble bath telling a story because I saw so many women taking bathtub selfies. I was like, I can't do that. I'm a man and I got hairy legs.
But you made fun
so
of
it. I made fun of it.
It worked.
And it worked. People thought it was funny. So just be you and have fun and take it day by day, like I said, because it's a long year. But at the same time, it goes by really quick, like really quick. So just stay in the moment and know that at the end of the day, you worked as hard as you could in whatever thing you're working for that day. And if it was a bad day, you know, like, you know, I won't make you talk, but, you know, Kathy and I are from Lebanon. She's really awesome. She's made an amazing transformation this past, like, year. And, you know, she's, there you go. Her and her husband go biking and running, and there's a really crazy hill in Lebanon called Tyler Hill that is super steep, and she's always walking, running up that thing, and I don't even think I ran up the full thing in my entire life. So kudos to her, because it's nuts. But you know, like, especially with running, and all workouts, you're going to have your days where you feel amazing, where you crush it and you're like on top of the world. You're high on life. You know, you got the endorphin rush, you're feeling great. And the next day you can go back and your workout and your run could suck. You're like, you're slow, your legs are heavy, you didn't eat enough, or you're not hydrated, whatever it may be. And that's why it's so important to focus on those positives. Like, you know what? Today is just not a good day for my workout, but I'm doing it. Like, that's the biggest thing, is you're doing it. And there's always a positive. Like I said, you could be having a crummy workout, but a crummy workout is better than no workout. So, you know, you'll live to fight another day and have a better day, and just keeping that even keel, you know, like, realizing that check mark off the day, go to the next day, just keep going, and that's, like I said, really what we're focusing on, working as hard as we can every single day, one day at a time, for the entire year, and then
compound effect.
Yep, and then we're going to see where we end up, you know, because if we do that to the best of our potential every single day for the year,
yeah,
it's going to be scary.
And we're going to be making sacrifices. Like, we were talking about it. Like, we're going to have to make sacrifices. Yeah, we'd rather go do other things. But, like, in a year from now, if we're where we, like, want to be, it's going to be so worth it, because we're going to have more time to go actually do those things.
Yep, so. Exactly. I don't mind sacrificing a year of hard work to get what I really want to better my situation. So, whether it's working this business, workouts, whatever, like, you totally... totally can do it.
Yeah.
Something too to like look forward to that I was super excited about was like this year, for some reason, like when they released the all access pass in like January, it was like I've just been coaching for 2 years. And so I'm realizing that like when they released the all access pass and then they had, you know, like come January, because January, it's so important to like send invites and plant your seeds and build your network throughout the whole year and having fun with it. But, and the reason why you do that is because, I mean, obviously you guys have heard it a million times, like send the invites, plant your seeds, grow your garden, you know, your harvest, is because when January comes around, like everybody wants to get fit. Like there was this funny meme where it was like, we're CrossFit, where like all these people were walking into like the CrossFit gym with like new CrossFit gear. And they're like, hey guy, haven't seen you in like 8 weeks, like I don't know where you were at, you know, like just because everybody comes back to it at that time. And this is the first time, I mean, probably because it's only been 2 years, but like I was so busy, like at the first, like I've been so busy, and I'm excited about it. Like it's so exciting to have like new people writing you, all these people that you're following up with, and then all your existing customers wanting to upgrade. And like the fact that, you know, the Beachbody is like, I waited on hold for 2 hours. I let my phone just sit there today to get through. And that, instead of like what Cam was saying, like back to the beginning of the mindset, like, why would I sit there? I turned it into a game because I'm a psycho like that. But like, I got on hold and I was like, what Beachbody coach is going to not be able to handle this, and they're just going to hang up because they're pissed off. And I was like, I was like, oh, maybe I'm like 1,000 in line. Let's see how many people like get knocked out because they don't have patience. So I was like, it was 1 hour and 47 minutes before I even got through. But I was like, I'm not backing down. Like, and so like in my head or whatever. So I was like, I can sit there and be like pissed that I'm on hold and be like, this is bullshit, blah, 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 blah. Or I could be like, this is so awesome that we're breaking the internet because of everybody's wanting to do this. Like, so you have to have that grit and you have to change your mindset. I don't know if Cam and Courtney have you guys do this, but I have my coaches do their like year goals the first of the year. And then, cause they're going to change no matter what you put for right now. And then I have them do their monthly goals and aim high. I mean, don't aim like Success Club 100. That's fine. But like, if you haven't even been hitting Success Club 5, like then that's not really realistic. Like aim more for like Success Club, like 10 or 20. So, and actually work to get there. It's important that you guys set goals that are realistic, that you can barely, like you'll hit. But with that being said, don't set your bar too low, you know, cause you can do a lot more than what you think that you can. So set those goals each month and just remember that like the start of your business and how this all happens is Success Club 5 and higher. Like when you start doing that, that's like the most important thing. I know that's your health and fitness and personal development is first, but then hitting Success Club. So it's like you got to do what you have to do that. And when you build that momentum, all the rest of the stuff follows along. So it's really about mindset and believing in yourself that you can do this. I've watched a lot of coaches say it's too hard. They can't do it. And I'm like, well, it's too hard on your mind because you did nothing. And you just told yourself like how bad, you know, you talked yourself out of it. So don't talk yourself out of it, because really what you're doing is talking yourself out of your own, like you're self-sabotaging your own health and fitness. And you just have to get comfortable with getting uncomfortable. I mean, it gets easier. You can ask my coach on this call, Bonnie. Like, there are things that probably she never thought she would do because she was completely uncomfortable, and then she's so happy that she did. Because now she's like, oh, I've done it. I could do it again. You know? Something I want to share with you guys. Like, I was on a roll with, like, following up that I've done this now, like, 3 times where I've, like, said, hey, girl, to a guy named Kelly or a guy named like Jamie, and then he's like, I'm not a girl. I was like, oh fuck, sorry, autocorrect, or sorry, I was in the zone. But I've done that so many times, and you guys can't be afraid of like doing that kind of stuff, because it's gonna happen. Like, those things are gonna happen. And I did this at the first summit that I went to. I did I don't know if you guys did it in Nashville, like the training that they had for $40 with Barbie and all of her top coaches. I don't know if you guys did that, like extra training. Well, they had made a YouTube video or a major video of like coaches from the beginning of like what not to do as a coach. And it was like hilarious. So it was like all these top coaches, and they shared all the things that they've ever done and everything that they've done wrong. And so you're going to do way more things like that along the way. So you just have to, I don't know, a good personal development book that I love is like Start by John Acuff. I think, I don't know if your team has read that book, but that's a really, really good book to start. So don't be afraid to mess up. But just remember to be yourself, because it's a lot more fun when you're talking about something that you want to talk about and doing something that you want to do. So you got to be selfish in a way when it comes to that too. And it's really important that you just put those blinders on and stay in your own lane. But come to the team for help and support and love, and because we are doing the same thing that you're doing. We're just doing it differently, you know? Okay.
No, you're good. Thanks for sharing. You always have good insights. We don't want to keep you guys too long. We've been trying to most of last year keep it like half hour, because people are busy, and you know, don't go too long with the calls, because we appreciate people taking time out of the day. But you know, if you do want to say something like before we end the call and get off here, if you want to unmute yourself or write the chat, if you have a question or comment, whatever, just do it blended and unmute yourself. You can just click your little screen window and say something if you want to or not. Doesn't matter. No pressure. You have anything to add to?
No, anything? I'm just excited for this year.
It's gonna be a good one. It's gonna be a good year, because if you make every day as happy and as positive as you can, that means your whole year is gonna be that way. Mm-hmm. You know, like, and I tell people this all the time. And especially when people give me excuses, and not coach wise all the time, but like people like, oh, I don't have any money, or like, oh, I'm trying to work out. I'm like, when you come to me with excuses, you better be prepared for solutions, because I'm a solution guy. I'll give you an answer to how you don't have an excuse, and you might not want to hear it. They're like, oh, I'm trying to work out. I'm like, wake up earlier. Oh, that sucks. I'm like, well, I gave you an answer. Sorry, you know? I'm like, oh, I have kids. I'm like, oh, okay. You know, you're right. I don't know anybody that has kids that works out. You're right. Like, come on. Like, I always have a solution. But I wanted to end with one thing that I thought was pretty cool that happened to me today. And it was all as a result of being real and raw. So I don't know if you guys saw my post last night about my back issues combined with running, but I have a lot of people that reach out to me about my running and say things like, you know, it must be so nice to be so fast. Like, you know, you run so fast, you're so lucky, it's because you're so young, you've been running forever. I just laugh and go, yeah, okay. Because I haven't been running forever. And, you know, I'm not as young as I was, you know, I'm still pretty young, but I shared something talking about where I was a couple years ago with my running, you know, like 11-minute miles, 12-minute miles, whatever. And now I'm running like sub 7-minute miles a lot of the time. And people see the now. They see what I'm doing right now and don't realize the backstory and where I came. So I shared like what I was running at a couple years ago. And just to show people like it took trial and error and lingering issues and, you know, stopping and starting and a lot of dedication to get to this point. You know, it's not a easy thing and it wasn't a quick thing. It's a year's process. Also shared about my back injuries I've been dealing with for almost 20 years now. And just to let people know, like, you know, I deal with stuff too. It's not always easy, but I have goals and I push through. Well, we were sitting here working today and I got a message from one of my old hockey teammates that I probably haven't talked to in like 2 or 3 years. You know, we're Facebook friends, but one of those people that, you know, you see them like see them once in a while on Facebook, but you never reach out to them. They don't reach out to you, just kind of get lost in the shuffle. Well, he messaged me and huge long message. And I was like, oh man. And he was letting me know that he was messaging me because he saw my post about my back issues. And that's something he dealt with hockey as well. And he's actually had surgeries and he's tried to go to chiropractors and therapists. And he did a surgery and it was good for like 3 months. And now he has like all these issues where his left leg goes numb and he has tingling in his back and his hamstrings are tight. And he lays on the floor with his kids and it takes everything just to get up on the couch afterwards. And he said, I saw what you're dealing with. I see that you're super into fitness because I quote, I see your posts all the time. So that shows consistency. He's like, you know, maybe you can help me out. You know, we used to be teammates. You're dealing with stuff too. You're into fitness. I want to try anything. And if you can help me out, I'll be your, one of your success stories. And I thought that was super cool that he said that and reached out because, you know, that's not always easy, but it goes to show sometimes you got to just be brutally honest and share the real stuff. I can't always be like, I had a great run today. It's sunny again today. Like, my body's great again today.
People like the struggle.
You gotta share the not so good sometimes to let people know that you're human and that you deal with stuff too. And that's why it's important to share that stuff. And I thought it was cool that he reached out to that. So maybe I'll be able to help him out, maybe not. But you know, it just goes to show don't be afraid to put yourself out there because, you know, there's other people on the other side of the computer or on their phone that are dealing with that same thing, and it takes you being brave and sharing about it to change your life and get them help. So it's important. But yeah, if nobody has anything to say or share, comment, whatever, we'll end the call. It's recorded for everyone who's going to be watching this later. Blaine, after I get it uploaded on my YouTube, I'll post your team page. I'll put it on our team page and, of course, on our team training website. But, you know, I want to say thank you to everybody for hopping on here. You're a big reason why we're successful and we love what we do, and getting to converse with you guys all the time is awesome, and we appreciate the support. And one of our team mottos is be gracious, be thankful, be positive. That's our 2017 cover photo, and that's really what we're going to focus on. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the call. Thank you for hopping on. If you haven't done a call with me about 2017 goals, I know a few of you have already. We could schedule that. But yeah, hopefully you guys have a wonderful evening and thanks for hopping on.
All right. We're done?
Yep.
Okay. Bye guys.
Bye.